hot. It's cold. It's cold, it's nice.
I thought you would be mine this Christmas. Ring, ring, ring. Hear the bells ringing on the Christmas tree. Minnesota winter snow is glistening.
What's up, y'all? Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Sonny, and today is Vlogmas Day 3/2. Bear with me. All right, y'all. So for this video, I'm literally just going to be showing y'all how I do my makeup, girl, because y'all be asking. And girl, some half the damn time, I don't even know what the fuck I be doing. I just be doing shit in hopes that it's going to come out looking okay. That's what I'm going to show y'all. And also, today is my baby's 3rd birthday. So y'all make sure y'all go say happy birthday to her. Girl, I don't care if this video is posted at goddamn 11 o'clock at night, because y'all know how YouTube be. Y'all better go comment and tell her happy birthday. And if y'all want to send her a little something for her birthday, girl, here's my Cash App tag. Since today is her birthday, I'm going to be doing like a little story time on when I went in labor, girl. So let's get into it, girl. So basically, the night before, December 15th, girl, I kept telling my boyfriend, I was like, I have to shit. Like, I felt like I was constipated or something. Like, I just felt like I had to shit and I couldn't go to the bathroom. Like, I kept on and kept on telling him, babe, I have to shit. And he was like, well, go shit then. And I was like, I can't. So the next day, I ended up having 2 different doctor's appointments. I had like a little anatomy ultrasound, which is like literally checking all of her body parts, making sure she got all her damn toes and shit like that. And then after that, I would go to my other doctor's appointment, and that was just to like check up on me, because the anatomy ultrasound was really just for the baby, for real. This right here is the She Glam Good Grip Primer. This shit is good as fuck. It's literally like a dupe for like the milk. Me personally, I think I kind of like this one better than the e.l.f. because I've seen a lot of people saying the e.l.f. primer was making like their makeup patchy and stuff. At first, it wasn't doing that for me, but I think it was only because I really didn't know what the fuck I was doing with the primer. Oh shit, that didn't go nowhere on my face, girl. No product left behind. I think I like this one a lot better. I think my first appointment was at like 10, and my other one was immediately after that, whenever I got done. So I was up at like fucking 8:30 that morning. I'm gonna try to like put a little clip in the video or whatever. And she was literally just up moving around, girl. And I thought, you feel me? She's just up, she's active, she's moving around. I didn't think that she was gonna fucking come that day. So when I ended up going to my doctor's appointment, I still felt the same way. I still felt like I had to shit and I couldn't go to the bathroom. So my doctor's appointment was at 10 o'clock. I went there. They did the little ultrasound or whatever. Everything was okay. And I had to go to my second doctor's appointment. Go to my second doctor's appointment and he's checking my cervix. And he was like, you haven't had any contractions or anything? I said, no, like I haven't felt like I haven't had any contractions. The concealer that I'm gonna be using is this She Glam, what is this? Bright Eyes Cooling Concealer. I really like this concealer. So I was like, no. And he was like, well, you're 4 centimeters dilated. And I was like, okay, what are we gonna do? He was like, well, I'm gonna go ahead and send you to the labor and delivery room because I don't want you to go home and have to come back out just in case the baby comes, blah 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 blah. So I'm scared as fuck. I'm like, bro, is this really happening right now? Like, she wasn't supposed to come. Her due date was January 2nd. That was her due date, and baby, she slid out 2 weeks early. I literally went to the car, called my mom and my sister, and was like, they just told me I'm 4 centimeters dilated, and he wants me to go to the labor and delivery room. It was just a lot going on, girl, and I was like, oh my God. Like, I didn't even know what to think, honestly. Like, I was like, I personally didn't think that she was gonna come that day. I didn't think that she was finna come, but she came, girl. I went to the hospital. The hospital was literally right beside, well, not right beside, but it's literally right there with the women's center or whatever. So y'all, I literally didn't even know where to go. I went in and I went to like the wrong part of the hospital. I was supposed to go in like the hospital. I went to like a different part where they had like people, like doctors with like people that was coming for like therapy and shit like that for like their back problems and ultrasounds and shit like that. I went to that part of the hospital. I didn't know where the fuck I was going. There was this lady sitting there. She was like the security guard or whatever. Today I'm gonna blend my concealer with this powder puff just to see how she does, because yeah, I ain't never tried her. He asked where I was going, where if I needed help going somewhere, and I was like, yeah, I'm looking for the labor and delivery room. She was like, oh baby, this is, you're in the wrong part. She was like, you're in labor right now. I said, I just left my doctor's appointment. He told me I was 4 centimeters dilated and he wanted me to go to the labor and delivery room. She was like, oh shit, oh shit. So she runs me to the place where I was supposed to go. Mind y'all, this is during COVID. I have a COVID baby. This was during COVID. Like, it was COVID, bitch. COVID. So there was like this lady. This woman's name was Karen. Yes, right hand of God, this woman's name was Karen. My auntie actually worked at that hospital. She's gonna come in a little bit later in the story. So there was like a little table there where they were making people sign in, because I mean, bitch, it was COVID. They needed to know everybody that was in the building or whatever. So I'm sitting there, the lady, the Karen bitch, she's sitting there talking to these two other ladies. I seen the bitch obviously look at me, but she wasn't playing me no mind. So there was another section where you had to sign in right there where Karen was, and then you had to go to another desk, and I guess that's where you found out what room you was going in and shit. So the lady was just sitting there at the other desk. She was looking at me. Bitch, I'm looking at her. Karen's looking at me. She's talking to these other fucking ladies. I'm like, okay, bitch, I'm finna go over here to this other lady, because you're not even doing your motherfucking job right now. So I'm walking my ass over there. She's like, hey. I turned around. She was like, you're supposed to sign in first. You gotta sign in. You can't just walk in here. I said, well, I'm in labor and you're sitting right here talking to these two women. You act like you didn't see me. She was like, oh, well, you have to sign in. So, bitch, I went over there. I signed in. That was strike one. That was definitely strike one. So, I go to the next desk or whatever. I get my room. They take me to my room. Mind y'all, I didn't have nobody with me because I didn't think that I was finna be in fucking labor that day. I didn't have nothing planned. Like, nobody was with me. I was literally by myself. My mom was at work. I had to call Marco. Marco had to come up there with me. Girl, it was just a lot going on that day. I wanted my mom in the room with me. My mama wanted to be in the room with me. And like I said, this was during COVID. So they really didn't let people like switch out. Like if you came in the room, if you was with the person in the room, like you couldn't switch out basically. That's what was going on. Like I said, I didn't know that I was finna go in fucking labor. They basically wouldn't let my mom switch out with Marco. And my mama ends up arguing with the Karen that was at the front desk, because she was basically telling my mama like, oh, well, if he's already up there with her, you're just gonna have to miss the birth of your granddaughter. You're just gonna have to miss it. You're just gonna have to miss it. And that's literally what she was saying. You're just gonna have to miss it. So, bitch, that my mama didn't take that too lightly. My mom was finna whoop that lady's ass in the hospital. Then this is where my auntie comes in. My auntie works at the hospital and she's basically trying to just calm my mama down. My auntie she's a very Christian, wholesome person. She doesn't like conflict or anything. So she's just trying to get everybody to calm down. You know what I mean? Eventually, the people let my mom and Marco switch. So my mom comes up there and girl, let's back up a little bit. Before my mom even got there, I personally didn't know if I wanted to go natural or not. I literally didn't know what I wanted to do. My doctor kept coming in there and he was like, what are you gonna do? Either you're gonna go natural or you're gonna get the epidural. And I was like, I don't know what I want to do. I don't know what I want to do. I don't know what I want to do. It was just so much going on at one time. I literally did not know what I wanted to do. It was so much pressure. I was overwhelmed. I'm having contractions now. And no shade, y'all, them contractions hurt. Like, them motherfuckers is not nothing to play with. He's like, okay, I'll be back in a few minutes and we're gonna have to figure out what you're gonna do. So I'm like, fuck, I gotta make up my fucking mind. He ends up coming back in like the next 30, 45 minutes, and he was like, okay, it's getting down to the nitty gritty. He was like, either you're gonna get it now or you're not gonna get it at all. And I'm like, fuck. So I just said, fuck it, give me the epidural. That right there was some scary shit. If y'all seen that fucking needle, that needle is literally like this long, like no bullshit. That's a long ass needle. And I'm already not too fond of needles anyways. Like, that's why, if y'all know me, y'all know I don't have no tattoos. Like, I have no tattoos at all. I really do want a tattoo, but I cannot constantly sit there and let that needle just keep going in my arm. Like, oh my god, I'm gonna have to have me some music, girl. Okay, let's not even talk about that right now, because it's giving me the heebie-jeebies a little bit. So he ends up giving me he didn't give me the epidural. The nurse came in, she gave me the epidural. And I will say, the nurse that was there, like, from the beginning when I went in there, the nurse that was like helping me and shit, she was really, really nice. I will say that the other nurses kind of gave like snobby, low-key, like they wasn't even talking to me, like they wasn't trying to help me, they was just doing their job. And I understand, bitch, that's what you here for, but you're a nurse, like, bitch, I'm in labor and you're supposed to be helping me right now, but and you're not. You're not. It was only literally one nurse. I wish I would have known what her name was, but she was really, really nice. She literally talked me through my epidural. She helped me basically the whole fucking time I was in labor. But after my epidural or whatever, I felt like I was on motherfucking cloud nine. I hadn't smoked in so long, in a long 9 months, but I was high, and I knew I was high. I was so high, y'all. Like, if you ever got epidural, like, you know what I'm talking about. Like, I was high. Like, I just felt like I was on a cloud and I was just floating. I felt great. I felt amazing. I truly did. I think that's when my mom finally got to come in. They ended up switching or whatever. I don't remember exactly what time I started pushing, but they kept on coming in. They was like, if you feel like any pressure or anything, let us know. If you feel like you have to push, let us know. Girl, I'm sitting there, and I just felt the urge to just push. And I'm like, bro, call them in here. I feel like I gotta push. They came in there. She checked my cervix. And I was at like 8 centimeters or like 7 or 8 centimeters, some shit like that. I don't know. But girl, all I know, it was time to push. I pushed maybe like, it was a good handful of times. I didn't push a lot. It wasn't really hard for me to get her out because of that epidural. Like, I was numb, y'all. Like, I'm talking about numb from the waist down. Like, I couldn't even pick my legs up. I was so numb. Like, that shit was crazy. So, yeah, that's my birth story. And it's really nothing to it, for real. Like, the only crazy thing about it is, girl, I literally just went for a checkup and, bitch, I was 4 centimeters. That's the only crazy thing about it, for real. And then the whole Karen situation was just like, she was just being a rude ass bitch. Like, she tried to sit there and act like she didn't fucking see me when I walked in. Bitch, you looked at me. I seen you see me. Like, I seen you. We were looking at each other. So there's no fucking way that you didn't see me walk in. A lot of y'all on my lives be asking me like how it was when I gave birth or whatever. It wasn't bad at all. Like, that epidural saved me. And I'm so glad that I got that epidural. Because, bitch, if I didn't get that epidural, I don't know what I would have did in there. So now that we're done with the birth story, I guess I'm just going to be telling y'all what I'm doing while I'm doing my makeup. So right now, I'm literally just contouring my nose. I really don't contour for real. Okay, this is the problem, y'all. This right here, this Fenty Beauty contour stick, this is a good ass contour stick. Now, I will say, this is the shade Mocha. I will say that it might be a little too bronzy for me. I have this right here that She Glam sent me, but I feel like she's just too cool for me. I feel like she's more for like the people, you know. I used her one time, but I wasn't really feeling it for real, so I just stuck to my Fenty Beauty because she just never lets me down. Really just put it on my nose, boop boop, and I use like this little angle brush right here, and I just blend, girl, just like this, up and down, up and down. I'd like to do it on the bridge of my nose first, like this. And then y'all see this little part right here? I turn her like this and I just blend her into my eye like this. And I do it like this just to really get that crease right there. And then I'll switch it and then I'll just go like this again. And then just tap. Vlogmas has been so stressful. Like, this shit has been stressful, and I feel like if I didn't have so much shit going on already in December, I wouldn't be, like, it wouldn't be like this. Because I've just had so much shit going on. Like, it's so many birthdays, parties, just events after events after events. And it's just like, oh my goodness. Like, whew. Okay, so now we got our contour and our concealer blended out. So now we're gonna move on to blush. This is literally my favorite blush right now, y'all. This, and I'm not gonna lie, this kimchi blush is actually really good too. This was my go-to before my She Glam and my Juvia's Place. I'm gonna show y'all the Juvia's Place that I got, girl. Baby, I have volume 5, and these two right here eats, like she eats. This is the shade Rose Ritual. Watch y'all. Baby, all you need is them two little dots right there. These are the Do You Care brushes. I love these brushes. Like, they're so soft. They sent me this case and everything, girl. Period. Watch how easy this blends out. Let me put the light right here for y'all. Do y'all see how easy she blends out? I love this concealer, but I feel like this is just a little too bright for me. This is the shade Fair. And I just feel like she's a little too bright for me. I don't know. Maybe I should try to put it on like a brush, like a flat brush, and then put it on and then blend it. That might help a little bit. But I think I'm gonna add just a little bit more blush. Today is not the day to be trying shit out, but blush is blended. I know it look a little crazy right now, but just bear with me and we gonna get her together. So I'm trying something new right now. Is it only me, or does your fucking makeup start itching? Like, your face just get the itching when you put, every time I put makeup on, my face starts to itch. Like, I don't know why I'm using the back of my hand when Shein literally sent me one of those trays that you can like put the makeup on and like mix together and shit. I don't know why the fuck I haven't used that. Anywho, so we're gonna let that sit for a minute, and we're gonna put my foundation on the bottom of my face. Just don't like putting foundation all over my face. Like, I don't know, I just don't. I have like a specific routine when I do my makeup, because like nobody actually taught me how to do my makeup for real. I've always been like a big beauty type of person. Like, literally when I was younger, I used to watch all the makeup girls on YouTube. It was just fun. Like, I was always so interested in it. I didn't know where to start when it came to my makeup. Like, I never knew where to start. I put it on my vision board last year to learn how to do my makeup for real, and bitch, I accomplished it, because I at least could do a full face and make it look like something. It might not be too fucking much, but I at least know what the fuck I'm doing just a little bit now. So now we're gonna blend this shit out in hopes that she does her one. I don't know. I'm telling y'all, I really think it's because this concealer is a little too bright for me. I would usually use this right here. This is the e.l.f. Camo Satin Finish Concealer. This is what I was using at first, and she was a little light too. I really like this NYX Can't Stop Won't Stop. This is really good. I only started using that NYX Can't Stop Won't Stop because Rissy was using that on my face. And she eats every time she does my makeup. It's like, when I use it, I can't get it how she be getting it. Girl, I don't know how the fuck she be doing it, but she does it. Now that we got our concealer blended out, I'm gonna go back in and blend my under eye before I set it with powder. Where's my powder? Girl, I do not play about this powder. This is the Laura Mercier powder. My man got me this for my birthday, and girl, she does her fucking one. I like to put this powder everywhere I put my concealer. Did y'all hear that? Y'all probably can't hear that, girl. My stomach just growled so goddamn loud. So now we're baking and blush is next. So we're gonna use Juvia's Plenty. Oh, fuck. That hurt. Oh my God. And I literally use the same brush that I use for my liquid blush. I really don't give a damn, honestly, truly. All you gotta do is this right here and you're good. Y'all see how much pigment? Like, and she don't come off, baby. She does not come off. I literally just brush her away like this. This is a lot of blush. This is a lot of blush. All right, y'all, I just went overboard with the blush a little bit. So I'm gonna take my little fluffy brush like this, and I'm literally just, let's knock this shit away first. This is my favorite bronzer. It's a powder bronzer. A little goes a long way. A long, long way. Y'all see, this is right here is the first product that I hit pan on. All you need is a little bit. I like to put a little bit on my forehead, like so. I think we done, y'all. Oh no, we're not done. The brows. I like to save my brows for last because I don't feel in my brows. I wish I knew how to do that, because if I knew how to do that and like conceal them and shit, I would do that first. But I literally only put this e.l.f. brow gel. This is really, really good, especially if you got like thick eyebrows like me, bitch. They not gonna go nowhere. I like to do it like this, brush it forward, and then I like to brush it back like this and up, because it's like you want to get every fucking hair that you got, bitch. You want to get it and you want to put that bitch in place. And I wish I had the little spoolie. They got the little flat thing on the end, but girl, I don't got that. So I literally just be using the back of my brush and doing them like this. They don't even look like twins, bitch. They're cousins. The hell? This right here is literally my favorite part of doing my makeup besides my blush. Wiping this shit off. Y'all, I want to get lip filler. I literally been thinking about this for a little minute now. It was really since like last year. I looked at my lips and I was like, bitch, your lips is a little thin, like just a little bit. I don't want my lips to be too much. I feel like I'm literally just gonna get them done one time and that's it. So if you do lips, bitch, and you want to do mine, hit me up. So now we're done with that, and I'm gonna set my face. I use the Stay All Night Micro Fine Setting Mist by e.l.f. I like to use her first, and then I go in with this one size on till dawn. This shit right here will make your motherfucking girl, your makeup's not going nowhere. It's not moving. Okay. I think that was my cue to go ahead and wrap this shit up. We got her. So now that we have done that, girl, I had a brown lip pencil. I have a brown lip pencil. Fuck, it's in there. I would have to go get up and get it. When I don't have a brown lip liner, girl, I literally just use brown eyeshadow and I don't give a fuck about it. Bolo head. Now I'm going to use my lip gloss. So once I fucking find it, it might be in here. Found it. It was on the floor. This right here is from She Glam's Harry Potter collection. And I really fucking love this lip gloss. I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's just the applicator, because these applicators like this, I love them. Like, they're not fuzzy. They're like the little silicone applicators. This is my favorite, and it just go on so smooth. And period. We're done. So we are done, and this is the final look. It's alright. It ain't too much. What I will say is I don't think I'm gonna be using that concealer as a brightening concealer anymore. Baby, I think I'm just gonna use what I've been using, because I don't know. Like, it's giving bright under eye, but I don't know. I feel like it's just a little too. I might need like a shade under. I don't fucking know. Or maybe it's the just way I'm putting it on. I don't know. But this is the final look. And yeah. So this is the end of the video, y'all. I hope y'all enjoy it. If y'all have any other suggestions on what y'all think I should do for a YouTube video or whatever, comment down below. Make sure y'all like, comment, subscribe, and share. And yeah. All right, y'all, I look a little crazy right now because it's the end of the day, and girl, I'm literally so stressed out. I'm tired. I probably look fucking tired, but girl, her party's tomorrow, and it's just so much going on right now. So before this video ended, I wanted to go ahead and show y'all these boots, that windbags that Rue sent me. Y'all probably remember them. They have sent me multiple bags for every time I work with them. It's A1 customer service, baby. I'm finna open these up and show y'all. I already tried these on, and girl, they're cute as fuck. I just need to find the right outfit for them. I gotta see what I want to give with the vibe, you know. But these are it. These are like some rubber Dior boots. It's kind of giving like rain boot low key. But this is what they look like. They're super, super cute. This is what it looks like at the bottom. The material up here is really, really soft, but then down here it's like rubbery. So this is what they look like side by side. They're so freaking cute, and I cannot wait to wear these. Shout out to Windbags Rue for sending me these super, super cute boots. Y'all, Lonnie wants to get up here. Come on. So if y'all ever need any bags, shoes, anything like that, make sure you hit up Windbags Rue, because baby, she's definitely gonna take care of you. So this is the end of the video. Make sure y'all like, y'all comment, and y'all subscribe, and comment below what y'all favorite color is, I guess. Bye. Kiss, blow kiss, blow kiss. So